Hello and welcome to Central News Center. I'm Sam.
And I'm Megan.
And today our first topic is Swanee with FBLA.
I wonder what FBLA means.
I think it means Former Burping League of America.
Probably.
Hi, I'm here with Gabe Randall, the president of FBLA.
That's me.
What are some of your goals of the chapter this year for you guys?
Well, this year, I think when it comes to like the officers' goal, I think the main goal was just growth and development, because last year we had around 20, almost 30 members, and this year we have around 30 to 40 and still coming in. So we got the growth aspect down, and we're trying to develop our chapter to become one of the best in North Dakota.
Is it true that you guys have state and national conferences?
Yes, we do. We have the state conferences in the winter, and then the national conference is in the summer. So this year, nationals will be in San Antonio, so can't wait to be there.
Do you know who's in charge of FBLA?
Well, when it comes to our advisors, that'll be Miss Cleveland and Mr. Lennon. They kind of, you know, make sure everything's organized, make sure the officers are doing well, make sure the chapter members are doing well, and make sure everything's running smoothly.
Anywho, I'd like to thank you for your time.
Thank you.
There again, President of FBLA, Gabe Randall. If you're interested to join FBLA, ask him, Mr. Lennon, or Ms. Cleveland. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now I will be interviewing Ms. Cleveland, one of the advisors for FBLA.
How many years of experience have you had with FBLA?
I believe this is my eighth year helping with FBLA. I was an advisor at my previous school for, I think, six state leadership conferences, and then this will be my second year at Central.
How do you register or how do you sign up for FBLA?
So students who are interested or who have been in it in the past, they are just able to come and visit with Mr. Lennon or I, and they pay a $10 fee, which is the amount that we have to pay the state and national office. So we don't keep any of that. And then they just have to fill out their code of conduct saying that they will behave, and then their medical release saying, or giving us their insurance information in case something happens while we are traveling. Other than that, they come to meetings, they prepare for their events. We have a few little parties here and there, and that is about it.
Now we got a local news stabbing with Jaden.
Sorry to hear about that.
On November 11th, 2018, in an apartment block of 3900 Garnview Drive, a reporter said a 20-year-old Akmal Asbaf told the police that he was the guy they were looking for. He was accused of stabbing a man, or a woman, sorry, with a silver knife, and in the other hand, he had a stone, a healing stone is what he called it. He told the police that he stabbed her because she was a witch, and she was causing negativity in his life, and he wanted to get rid of it. I had asked Kate Smothers and Carter Smilvog what they had to say about this news report. Here's what they had to say.
Okay.
All right, Kate, do you believe in witches?
No.
You do not? Do you think this ass-off guy is crazy?
I believe that, yes, he may be mentally incapacitated at the time. However, I do feel that the charges are appropriate.
Okay, that's good. What do you think the healing stone was?
I believe the healing stone was probably a rock or something along that line, which in his mind believed would correctly heal things.
Right. So why do you think overall he did this?
I believe he was possibly mentally incapacitated at the time. However, he still needs, I believe, to have the charges against him.
Perfect. Thank you, Kate. Do you believe in witches?
No.
You do not? Why?
I just don't think they're real.
Okay. What's your reaction to this news?
It seems kind of crazy that it happened here and that somebody would think that somebody else is a witch and they were murdering them.
Yes, I agree with you. Do you think he had a motive, or why do you think he did this?
Well, he was probably just crazy and he thought that woman was a witch.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Wow, that seems serious.
Next, we have Triana with a UFO sighting. Even more serious.
At 6:47 on November 9th, 2018, a UFO was spotted off the Irish coast. A British Airways pilot contacted Shannon Air Traffic Control. She wanted to know if there were any military exercises going on in the area because there was an unidentified flying object. I interviewed Lucy Welsh. Here's what she had to say. Okay, so do you believe in aliens at all?
Yeah, I believe there's probably some other sort of species out in outer space somewhere.
Okay. Do you think UFOs are real?
Maybe not, maybe. I don't know.
Do you think it could be the government covering something up?
Yes, for sure.
Some astronomers believe it was just a shooting star. Do you think that could be one of the possibilities?
Maybe. Some people see things that aren't really there sometimes.
What do you think it could have been?
I don't know. It could have been a UFO.
And have you ever seen a UFO before?
Not a real one.
I hope ET was visiting. Now we have Andarisa with random questions.
Segment of Central News Station. I'm your host, Adarisa Santiago, and today I asked some Central teachers some Central trivia. So let's see how they did. Just a disclaimer before we begin, all the teachers I interviewed gave me full permission to record. They gave me full permission to record them. So yeah, let's get started.
In what year was Central established?
Nineteen eighteen.
Okay. Take that as an answer.
Is that correct?
Well, I can't tell you that. Maybe you'll see it on the news.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Ellen, but that's wrong. Central was actually established in 1881. Pretty old.
All right. Okay. So, name two sports that Central does not offer.
Lacrosse and downhill ski.
Okay. Can you name one that it does offer?
Girls basketball.
And that is correct. Not that I know anything about sports. Moving on.
Who is the best teacher at Central?
Currently, that would have to be Miss Bridget Ryberg or Mr. George Dubois.
See, opinion, it was easy. You didn't have to worry about it. What?
Tape again.
Why?
Just hit record.
Well, I am hitting record.
Oh, Mr. Nick Graves.
Now you gotta edit that.
Okay.
I'm sorry, but that's wrong. The only valid answer for that question was Mr. Lennon. But you tried. That was a joke, Mr. Myrold. Please don't give me an F.
How many students were in the first graduating class of Central? Okay. Well, thank you.
And that is correct! The first graduating class of Central originally had 10 students, but only 2 of them graduated. But still. Okay, moving on.
So, do you know if Central has a swimming pool?
Yes, they do.
Where is it?
It is located, my son used to be on the swim team. So, if you go toward the gym, and there's an area that's kind of off over to the left, you go down a hallway, and then you go back down in there and you'll find the pool.
That's probably right, but I couldn't say because I've never been to the swimming pool.
Okay.
Also, do you know which school is the oldest operating in North Dakota?
No. I am just going to guess that it's Radford Central, but I don't know that for sure.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, that's all.
I'm sorry, but that's wrong. The oldest operating school in North Dakota is actually Red River! Nah, just kidding, it's Grand Forks Central. Now for some interactive trivia. I'd like to know your answers to this question. When did the construction of Central begin? This was Mrs. Levinsky's answer.
In what year did the construction of Central begin? Okay.
Before this segment ends, I'd like to give a round of applause to the teachers that I interviewed for being good sports and letting me record them. So let's give a round of applause. Well, okay, that's all for this segment. Hope you had fun. See you later, probably, on the best trivia segment you've ever seen in your life.
Now, Lewis is going to talk a little something about freshman basketball.
Please state your name.
Khalil Nicholson.
What grade are you in?
I'm in the 9th grade.
So I'm going to be asking you some questions about basketball. Why do you plan on joining basketball?
I just have this feeling whenever I'm playing. It's just like a connection, like a spark. And yeah, that's what we're doing. It's just like life for me.
Oh, nice. Do you have any advice for those who are like debating on if they should join basketball or not?
Listen, you should always try new things. Try basketball. It's like amazing once you get like the hang of it. That's what we're doing.
So how long did it take you to get the hang of it?
It took me about like a year.
How long do you plan on playing basketball in high school?
The whole year, like the whole 4 years.
Do you feel like the transitions from middle school to high school is gonna be different? Like the basketball's a lot, is it gonna be a lot harder?
Most definitely. It's gonna be like way more competition. Gonna be like way taller competition. You have to watch out for that. And people are just going insane.
So, are you aiming to join the freshman team or C squad or what team are you aiming to join?
Probably, I'm thinking about joining JV. JV seems pretty good. If I'm like that good, hopefully I can join JV, really.
Any tips on getting better at basketball?
Practice. You have to consistently practice if you want to get better.
Okay, thank you for your time. Please state your name.
Jacob Copeland.
Today I'm going to be asking you some questions on basketball. So, why do you want to join basketball?
To stay in shape for football.
So you're a football player?
Yes.
Any advice on those who are like debating on joining basketball?
you know, basketball is my favorite sport, but try out. Why not, right? Give it your best.
What's the thing that about basketball that you like the most?
Defense. You change the offense to defense in a matter of seconds.
Do you feel like the transitions from middle school to high school is different? Like, do you feel basketball is going to be a lot harder?
No, because you're playing against other people in the same grade, so it's not that big of a difference. Just wearing a different color.
Oh. Do you have any tips on getting better at basketball?
Just keep working at it. That's all I can say.
How long are you going to play basketball in high school?
Depends on this year.
So this year is the decider.
Yep.
Freshman basketball, good luck this season. Next we have Evan with the wrestling season.
All right, so I'm here with Tyson Guess. We just got done with our walking tournament. And how has the season been going for you besides getting the huge dub at this tournament here?
It started off a little different than I thought it would be. First 2 years I've wrestled, I've always won my first match at Valley City. This year I lost mine, so that was a pretty big setback, which sucked, but I pulled the win out at back at Central, so that really helped me out with this.
All right, and then how have you guys been working your training regimen into like live drills and that stuff?
When we go live, we just go at it. So me and my partner, we do exactly what we do in a match on the mat. So we get to work all that really well and it helps a lot. All
right. And then where do you guys see yourself seating in state time coming up in February?
Right now with the coaches survey, I'm seated fourth. I'm probably going to expect by the time that state comes around, I'm going to say fifth or sixth.
All right. Thank you for your time. Yeah.
Next, we have Evan with student Christmas plans.
My name is Ambe.
Are there any Christmas plans that you have this year?
I'm going to go back home, you know, celebrate a little bit with my family, you know. And, you know, why not?
Are you traveling anywhere this year?
Well, first off, going back to Minneapolis, probably going down to Georgia or Chicago somewhere.
Any special traditions you'd like to share?
I mean, we don't really have any because we always just make up a new day every year.
All right, thank you.
No problem.
All right, Sam, do you have any plans this Christmas?
Yeah.
Holiday season?
Yeah.
All right, can you tell us about those plans?
Going to my grandpa's house, have some food, open presents. Yeah.
Are you traveling anywhere this Christmas?
No. In town.
And is there any traditions you'd like to share?
No.
Merry Chrysler and Happy Holidays from the Central News Center. Next we have Trinity with another media review. This one's about Christopher Robin and Teen Titans.
Thanks guys. Hi, my name's Trinity and I will be reviewing the movies Christopher Robin and Teen Titans Go to the Movies. Christopher Robin is a movie about Disney's Christopher Robin, who, when he grows up, and it gets a little bit complicated in his life because he's turns into a workaholic, and it's kind of sad. But things get better when Winnie the Pooh shows up.
Pooh? Christopher Robin! No!
I love the animation in this movie. They make the characters look so cute. It's just unbelievable. They're so adorable. Anyway, he and his wife's daughter runs away, but they find her with Winnie the Pooh and the group, and it's just this whole big adventure of them trying to get back home and trying to get Winnie the Pooh back home and them trying to get back to London, and yeah, it's just a big mess, but it's a really cute movie. I would definitely recommend it. I would give it 4.5 out of 5 stars. Next, I will be reviewing Teen Titans Go to the Movies. This movie is actually really funny. I enjoyed it a lot. I didn't think I was gonna like it as much as I did. I thought it was gonna be like kind of dumb, but it wasn't. My favorite part was when they met Slade for the first time, which is the main antagonist in the story, and they called him Deadpool. It was pretty funny.
Deadpool?
Deadpool? What? Why does everybody think I'm Deadpool?
I thought Deadpool was a good guy.
By the way, he should be saying that he's not me, okay? Because I came out like way before he did.
All about Robin trying to get himself a movie. because he sees that all the other superheroes are getting movies, even Alfred, Batman's butler, if you don't know who that is, he even gets his own movie. So this is just Robin's whole quest of trying to get himself a movie so that he can feel like a real superhero. Yeah, this movie was pretty great. I enjoyed it a lot, and I would definitely recommend it. I would give this movie 4.5 out of 5 stars also.
A Batman! Batman Returns! Batman Forever!
There is no stopping the Batman.
Thanks for watching. Back to you guys.
Looks like good media. Thanks for watching.
And peace out from Central News Center.